Hello everyone, you're very welcome to our Sunday school service on Pentecost Sunday. To everyone who has joined us for today's service, thank you. We're sure this service will have something for everyone. Enjoy and thank you.
Lord Jesus, we confess to you the wrong things we have thought, said, and done. We are sorry that we haven't loved you or loved other people. Thank you that you died for us and rose again. Please forgive us and set us free for the glory of your name. Amen. and some words of reassurance of God's forgiveness when we turn to Him. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who has promised forgiveness to all who repent and have true faith in Him, be merciful to us, pardon and set us free from all our sins. Strengthen us in His service and bring us to eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Well, with it being a Sunday school closing service this week, some of the boys and girls, and thank you very, very much for the wonderful suggestion, also some parents undoubtedly were involved, came up with a wonderful idea to pass some gifts around the parish from the children to largely the older members of our parish, but also there being some exceptions to that as well. So thank you, boys and girls, for that lovely idea. And we've got some wonderful gift bags, and some people have received their gifts today, this being Saturday, and others will receive them over the next few days as well. It's been a difficult time. Nobody needs me really to repeat that, but it's been a difficult time, particularly if you have been in the position where you have been locked down and unable to travel to your usual activities or visit your friends or your family or have them visit you. It's lovely to be able to show a little bit of kindness to one another at this time. So thank you once again, boys and girls. Special prayer for this, the day of Pentecost. Let us pray. Almighty God, who on the day of Pentecost sent your Holy Spirit to the apostles, with the wind from heaven and in tongues of flame, filling them with joy and boldness to preach the gospel, by the power of the same Spirit, strengthen us to witness to your truth and to draw everyone to the fire of your love through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Thank you.
Prophet Zephaniah, chapter 3, beginning at verse 9. Then I will purify the lips of the peoples, that all of them may call on the name of the Lord and serve him shoulder to shoulder.
From beyond the rivers of Cush, my worshippers, my scattered people, will bring me offerings. On that day, you, Jerusalem, will not be put to shame. For all the wrong things you have done to me, because I will remove you from your arrogant boasters. Never again will you be haughty to my holy hill.
But I will leave within you the meek and humble. The remnant of Israel will trust in the name of the Lord. They will do no wrong. They will tell no lies. A deceitful tongue will not be found in their mouths. They will eat and lie down, and no one will make them afraid. This is the word of the Lord.
Superman, I'm spirit led, Holy Spirit to the rescue. Hello everybody, how are we? It's Moira, one of your Sunday school teachers. I hope you're all well, I hope you're all safe, and I hope you're all enjoying this lovely weather we're having. Me and all the rest of the Sunday school teachers miss you very much, and we hope you're all safe and well, and we hope to see you all very soon. Now today, we're going to be looking at the book of Acts. Some of you may remember this is what we looked at in our Sunday school lessons this year. But to help me explain some of our stories from the book of Acts, I'm going to go on a walk of my family farm and you're going to come along with me. As you can see here, I've come down to the Shannon Erin waterways and we're going to talk about Jesus's going back up into heaven. This is also known as ascension, and within this is Jesus going up into heaven again, and he talks about John the Baptist baptizing you with water, and the Holy Spirit will come down and baptize you after. So, as you can see here, we are with the sheep, and we're going to take a look at Acts 2. Now, in Acts 2 is Pentecost, and this is when the Holy Spirit came down and filled the earth. And this happened when a group of people were all together and didn't understand each other. They spoke different languages to each other. And Peter and the disciples were teaching God's word. And when the Holy Spirit came down, everybody could understand Peter and understand each other. And a flame of fire became above their heads. Now, this is just a miracle that through the Spirit of God, they were able to understand each other and speak to each other. As you can see here, we're sitting on top of the bales and we're going to take a look at Acts 10. And within Acts 10, it talks about Peter having a vision. And within this vision, he envisions a big sheet with all the animals he cannot eat as a Jew. And he's been told to eat these and kill them and eat them. So the meaning of this is that it's okay to eat them as they're clean and pure by God, and that it's okay also to go and speak about God and to spread the good news of Jesus. Now that's the end of my talk. I want to thank you for coming round on the farm with me this evening, and I hope to see you all very soon.
I read from the book of Acts, chapter 2, beginning at the first verse. When the day of Pentecost came, they were all together in one place. Suddenly a sound like the blowing of a violent wind came from heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire and separated and came to rest on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit enabled them.
Now they were staying in Jerusalem, God-fearing Jews from every nation under heaven. When they heard this sound, a crowd came together in bewilderment, because each one heard their own language being spoken. Utterly amazed, they asked, "Aren't all these who are speaking
Galileans.
Then how is it that each of us heard them in our own native language? This is the word of the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Have I heard the word Gentile before?
I know what it is. It's like a reptile, but more gentle. A gentle reptile is a Gentile.
I'm pretty sure it's not.
No, it isn't. As we've learned, Jews were the children of Israel who were still faithful to God, mostly from the tribes of Judah, Benjamin, and Levi. If you were Jewish, you saw the world as two groups, Jews and everybody else. And they called the everybody else Gentiles. Thanks to all the Pharisees' rules, most Jews wouldn't even talk to Gentiles.
Oh, so the world was made up of Jews and Gentiles, and a Gentile was anyone who wasn't a Jew. Gentle reptiles aren't Jews, so therefore, gentle reptiles are Gentiles.
Your logic almost works, but not quite.
That's...
I want us to think for a few moments about those words from the book of Zephaniah earlier on, read by Rowena and Emma and Carrie. Zephaniah chapter 3, verses 9 to 13. Zephaniah is a very short book, just three chapters in length, and essentially to summarize it, the first chapter is all to do with how God will judge the nations all around Israel. And then the second chapter is once again how he is going to judge all of the nations, but tagged on to the end of the chapter is also Israel, and how there is no real distinction in this book between the other nations and Israel, because Israel had essentially become like the other nations. And so some of the other prophets, they kind of almost take the other nations and Israel as they take them separately when they're describing God's judgment or what it's going to be or what has to come to pass. But in this second chapter of Zephaniah, it's almost like the prophet is speaking about God regarding the two entities as the same thing. But then in chapter 3, a much more positive situation where it's being revealed that God will restore Israel. He will restore his own nation. He will restore his own people in keeping with the promises of his great covenant. And so we were reading about these four verses, or five verses, sorry, chapter 3, verses 9 to 13. And it was talking about this idea that for at that time I will change the speech of the peoples to a pure speech. And just to recount a little bit of the Bible story, which hopefully you will be familiar with, but if we go as far back as the Tower of Babel story in the Old Testament, and how God was not pleased with his people back then, and how he could see that when the people got together under their own devices and whatnot, they were liable to come up with all kinds of rebellious schemes. And so God, it says, separated the people. He spread them out far and wide, and he confused their languages so that they would not have the ability to communicate in the same way as they were doing so beforehand. So this verse then from Zephaniah is very, very interesting as we think of Pentecost, isn't it? This is a number of hundreds of years before Pentecost, but it is talking about this idea of how God will change the speech of the people to a pure speech, that and the reason for that is that all of them may call upon the name of the Lord and serve him with one accord. And people will come from far and wide, the dispersed. It says, from beyond the rivers of Cush, my worshippers, the daughter of my dispersed ones, shall bring my offering. And nobody shall any longer be haughty in my holy mountain, but rather they shall seek refuge in the name of the Lord, and there will be not found in their mouth a deceitful tongue, for they shall graze and lie down, and none shall make them afraid. It's a real picture of restoration. And you see, as we consider the events of the cross and the events of the resurrection, and 40 days later, as we talked about last Sunday, Ascension Day, and how Jesus ascended back into heaven, promising his disciples that as he went, they were to remain within Jerusalem. We have been studying the book of Acts, as Moira mentioned earlier. Good enough, Sunday school has been not happening for a couple of months now, but we were looking at the book of Acts from the start of the year. And it's this idea that on the day of Pentecost, there was Many, many people assembled in Jerusalem, waiting for God to send his promise to waiting for the great event to take place before they would move out from Jerusalem as Jesus had commanded. Go not only into Jerusalem, but into Judea and Samaria and all of Israel and into the ends of the earth. And then on that day of Pentecost, there came the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit allowed the people to communicate with one another, even though they were from many different countries and many, many different languages. You see, as has been our theme for our service today, this theme of unstoppable, and it's a wider theme of the book of Acts in general, because we have looked at the first 12 chapters of the book of Acts over this last number of months, and throughout the book of Acts, all we can see is that despite great challenges, despite great persecution, despite problems galore towards God's people and towards the early Christians, God was unstoppable. His gospel is unstoppable. His mission is unstoppable. And it was unstoppable then, and it is unstoppable now. And perhaps that's the very thing that you need to hear today, that the work of God in the world and in our country and in our local community and in our church, in our parish, is unstoppable. That may be a surprise to you today, but God is continually at work. He is at work in you. He is at work in many people, and he is at work in the wider parish. And despite many, many challenges that we see in the book of Acts, think for a moment. Think about the stoning of the first martyr in Acts chapter 6 and 7, the stoning of Stephen. And at that point, the early disciples were dispersed and sent to many, many different areas outside of Jerusalem. And probably if you were watching at that time, you were watching from the outside, you maybe thought, well, that's the end of that movement already. But actually, by the disciples becoming dispersed like that, they were actually increasing their ability to bring the gospel to many, many more people. And then we have the Apostle Paul and all that he was doing in the way of persecution and trying to prevent the early Christians from meeting and from assembling and from praising God and worshipping the Lord Jesus. But God's ways are unstoppable, and Saul was converted, and in time he would become probably the most famous of all the apostles, and he would become at least one, if not the apostle who bore the most fruit in many, many countries around the world in terms of the gospel. And then, as Moira mentioned earlier on, the whole story of the Apostle Peter, who, as a God-fearing Jew, he observed the Jewish law, and he didn't want to eat anything unclean or anything like that. But God got his message through to him that nothing that he has made clean is unclean. And he meant this in reference to the Gentile people, the non-Jewish people. We saw that in our little video earlier, what is a Gentile, from the What is in the Bible team. And, God was saying nothing is unclean. Nobody is unclean that I have commanded you to tell the gospel to. And with that, he was instructing Peter and Paul and many others to go out into all the different nations and to bring the gospel. And it's a command which he still gives to his people today. And if you are a follower of the Lord Jesus, this is the command for you also. Boys and girls, we are told to follow Jesus. We are told to love him. And we are told to tell many people about him. And I just want to leave you, boys and girls, as we close our Sunday school season, to thank you for all that you have done, and for all the joy that you bring many, many people here in the church, and for how it is a great encouragement to see so many wonderful young people here in the parish. But we must also not forget and never forget that the main reason why you are here, the main reason why any of us are here, is so that we can grow in our faith with Jesus Christ. And I would urge you today to continue to take steps, no matter what age you are, and for your parents to continue teaching you at home, as they have been doing during the lockdown with schoolwork and all the rest of it, but continue to teach the boys and girls the Bible, teaching them about Jesus and teaching them about God, who loves them so very, very much. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we give you praise and thanks this day. We thank you that the Lord Jesus died for us. We thank you that he rose again. We thank you that he ascended into heaven, and that by leaving, he sent his helper, the Holy Spirit, who is the one who teaches us and encourages us to love Jesus, encourages us to be sorry for our sin, and encourages us and enables us to tell other people about Jesus. We give you thanks in his most precious name. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father. From there he will come and to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Dear Lord, we thank you for who you are and all that you have done in our lives and in human history. We thank you for our family, our friends, and our school, which we miss a lot, but hopefully it will return soon. Lord God, you are the greatest I am. We praise you this day through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Dear Lord, thank you for our Sunday school and our teachers.
And for everything.
And for everything we have learned and enjoyed the whole year through.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Dear Lord, we thank you for this special day of Pentecost when your church was born. We We thank you that the Holy Spirit came to help all the followers of Jesus. Tell others about him through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Dear Lord, we thank you for your love in every season of life. The last few months have been difficult for many people. People have lost loved ones, and others have had to work in very difficult conditions. Help us to trust in you all more as a result of time, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Faithful God, who fulfilled the promises of Easter by sending us your Holy Spirit and opening to every race and nation the way of life eternal, open our lips by your Spirit, that every tongue may tell of your glory, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Thank you all for joining us today. We hope that you are keeping safe and we'll see you soon.
Let's say a closing prayer together for Pentecost. Spirit of life, Spirit of power, Spirit of love, Spirit of creativity, Spirit of eternity. Amen.